a restless seeker on private business, arrived in the misery-infested land. She, despite ignorance, uncertainty, and unhappiness in her own life, could not endure to see them suffering. She began to fight against the savage murderers, abusers, and defilers without quite knowing why or for whose sake she truly fought, or how the struggle would end.
all this way to find a simulacrum?
If I had the time, I'd detail how often you prefer dealing with illusions rather than the real thing. Problems you refuse to deal with don't exist. You deny reality.
That's not right. I know what's real.
No? Then you allow others to tell you what isn't real. Now, come inside.
My memories are shattered. This wicked train has ruined nearly all I can recall. And Wonderland will perish completely as I lose my mind. So much has changed. I can't help Wonderland if I can't help myself.
Much has changed, but you've got it backwards. Save Wonderland and you may save yourself. The carpenter was onto something, but he was hiding from the real. Your goal is to accept it.
Where should I go then? What should I do?
The Queen must be served, Alice. The Queen, in all her guises, must always be served.
How can she stem this growing corruption or assist my search? What does she know that I don't?
She is someone you once knew and loved. Time changes us all.
Not all change is good.
Remember that when you find the Queen.
Oi, you there. That's enough of that. Coming a regular this, Nick Ellis. We'll see this time, Fred.
Howling outside the old lady, muttering about a murder in Threadneedle Street, cursing insects on the National Railroad. Had to bring her in, didn't I?
Cha-cha-cha-cha, menace to herself. But no danger to have her, surely. She don't belong in jail.
Too true, but where then does she belong?
Let's walk her out, Fred. Send her back to Dr. Bambi. He raised holy hell last time I kept her overnight.
Oh, what happened?
Same night Jack Splatter, that waste of mother's love, was nabbed for gutting that heavy outside a mermaid. Yeah, I was taking Alice down and we meet two coppers walking Jack to the cells. He's mad in the usual I'd never wrong bloke nonsense when he sees Alice. That's the bitch what done it, he yells. She screams, you miserable cur, you leech, you maggot, living off another's labour, etc., etc. I'm admiring her line of inquiry, but suddenly she hits her head or something and faints. Couldn't send her home, could I?
And Dr. Bumby pitched a fit.
Said he'd have me jobbing me arse on a plate. Told him he could have the former. Leave the latter alone, thank you very much. Good night, Alice. You know the way out.
Thank you.
Claimed I'd stolen his heart. Trifling with his affections. Creepy sod. Touching me. Told Papa to never invite him to tea again.
Thank you. light? Light is useless if what it illuminates causes pain and suffering. Better to cast such things into the dark depths of Lethe, the river of forgetfulness.
Back to admire your handiwork, returning to the scene of the crime.
It had to be done, Cat. You said so yourself. You and this Red Queen cannot both survive. She is a cancer in your body. Excise her or perish.
Well, she was the face of evil in the heart of darkness.
She didn't treat you too well last time, lost your head as I recall.
She was completely deranged. You picked up her crown, but now you've put it down. You must speak to her, what's left of her anyway.
With her here. Welcome, Alice. Here's a little something to keep your brain
dead. What comes next in the sequence? 1, 3, 4, 7, 11.
Wrong, wrong, and wrong. What always runs but never walks, often murmurs, never talks, has a bed but never sleeps, has a mouth but never eats. Are you pretending to be dense? I never was, am always to be. No one ever saw me, nor ever will. What am I? Righto.
The Red Kingdom's in ruins, but you're no better off.
When you defeated her, I tried to reclaim the castle, but I was set upon by her monstrosities. The malignant royal bitch still reigns.
I'm here to petition her. I must get inside.
The only way in is through me. Sacrifices must be made.
Those who say so usually mean they should be made by others.
Cynicism is a disease. It can be cured. Once inside, beware of the outsized killer who patrols her domain. Never confront him. He is invincible. Now cut me loose. I'll show you the meaning of sacrifice.
Games, too, require hard choices. Unpleasant sacrifices must often be made to accomplish your desired goal.
Every picture tells a story. You wouldn't tolerate a book without pictures when you were a girl.
Bearskin rug before the hearth, no deer antlers on the wall, no taxidermic abominations in the house, demeans the creature's dignity.
Thank you.
I'm an idiot. Don Quixote had a better chance with his windmills, without risk of decapitation.
A prudent exit is no less so for being hasty. Queen's guardian rarely leaves his filthy lair, but you're special.
A weapon's intended function is almost beside the point. Ultimately, it's only as good as the person who wields it.
To decapitate intruders only at your peril.
locked room is little more than a cage, a prison by another name. I despise concealment of any kind.
For the queen, but remember, she also has eyes for you.
Born in the ruined sanctuary of Los Alice, picture Madame Defarge knitting away as deserving heads roll from the guillotine. Ah, those were good days.
Does not overstay. A perfect guest stays home.
Thank you.
Lovely service, beautiful music, closed caskets, though I'm told your sister could have shown to advantage. The flames never got to her.
There's no time to waste. There's no time at all. Come, Alice, don't dawdle. You've already missed the train.
To the royal guards of this realm, we are all victims in waiting.
Ha 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 ha!